Time now for Homeschooled as we welcome in Sal Licata and Mark Malusis. And fellas, much like last Friday, it was not a work of art, but Sal, what has impressed you the most about the Mets' recent resiliency?
Well, I'll tell you, I thought tonight it was the bullpen in particular. Behind Stroman, right, the team struggles, whether it's defensively or struggling to score runs. How about the bullpen, for the most part, keeping it at bay? We could talk about the depth and covering up their injuries and things like that, but how important of an inning for Jarice Familia, right? Where Familia, instead of imploding like, say, others would do in a non-save situation or in a spot where you're not protecting the lead, he doesn't implode, keeps the ball game within reach, and then the Mets go out there and their bats do it in the ninth inning. So things like that, they're doing it in different ways, whether it's walking with the bases loaded, cheap walk-off hits, finding ways to keep the game close until they eventually get big hits and breakthrough. It was nice to see Dom Smith. So I think it's been a little combination of everything. They're starting to come together as a team. Not one guy is carrying them. They're playing sound, solid team ball for the most part and able to win some of these games for six straight here.
The Mets' depth has been on display throughout the year. We've been talking about it for a while. But, Moose, how would you describe what Kevin Pillar and Jonathan Villar have meant to this team?
Well, I mean, the quality depth, I mean, it's something we've talked about for a while here, right? When you've looked at the starters on the Mets, when they've gone down to injury, some of them, you know, you looked at the bench and said there's really not many answers. Well, there is quality depth on this team. I mean, the Jonathan Villar can do a lot of different things. You've seen it on the base pass. You've seen him play multiple different positions. He provides an element to this team. He's got a high baseball IQ. You consistently see that. You look at Kevin Pillar. Kevin Pillar's been a guy that has been a really good defensive center fielder for a lot of winning clubs, providing some offense as well. So, I mean, you add to it, to this team, and we talked about the starters, and the starters are going to really carry the way offensively for this team, but you're going to need quality backups, and you're going to need backups that can go out there and play multiple positions as well and provide solutions and give this team quality at-bats or step in and play defensively or step on the base pass and go out there and be aggressive and maybe steal a base and scratch across a run. You've seen that this year with this team, and you haven't seen that in quite some time. It's really a credit to Sandy and his staff for what they did in the offseason, adding quality veteran ball players to this bench, because clearly this team needs it, as does every team in baseball.